Hello, everybody. Welcome back to another episode of Evan Better Presents. So, still running into a serious problem with power. This episode I told you I was going to fix that. Well, the fastest way to fix that is to put down solar panels. As you can see here, I've put down, a couple thousand solar panels. No, that's not true. How many do I have? A couple thousand. Okay. So, I got all these solar panels here. I need to put more. I need a lot more. Like, tons more. So, I started doing it manually again, and I was getting a little annoyed with how, monotonous it was. Well, there goes all of our accumulators into action. And I thought, why? Why am I doing this the stupid way when I don't need to? I can do this the frickin' awesome way. Which is blueprints! This is the whole point of blueprints, guys. If you've never used blueprints, this is what they do. You simply copy an area, and it can be, as you'll see, massive. A massive, massive area. Boom. You now have a blueprint. And you simply just take it, and you place it down. Alright, I got a couple things that are going to interact there. It's not a big problem. Damn it is a big problem because I can't get... I was one too many wide there. I wasn't really paying attention to where I started that. Shit. Was it here? I think it was here. Let's try this one more time. See if we can't get the right size. And let's pay better attention to what I'm doing this time for when it doesn't fit. So yeah, this is the way that blueprints work. You just drag this son of a bitch over the area you want to blueprint. And then you simply take your new fresh blueprint. There we are. That's better. And you drop it down. Just like... Damn it. Just like that. And now you sit back while the robots do all the work. Watch this. This is always really cool to watch. Look at that. Boom. Done. Fracking done. Done. Look how easy that was. Well, we got a couple that don't have power. That's fine. I can fix that easily enough. That's all there is to it, kiddos. Why do it the stupid way when you can do it the robot way? There we go. And that's all there is to it. As the robots have the materials to do it, they simply build it for you. Doesn't always work perfectly, because sometimes they run out of materials. They gotta make a long trip. That time it worked because I had just disassembled everything I had just started making to do that. Alright. Now I just need to... Yeah, we're out of... Alright, so they don't have any more of those in stock, the these guys here, because I have never made them. So, they have no source to gather them from. The only way they were getting them before is because I had made a whole ton of them and stuck them into my inventory to get rid of them. Which actually will still work, because now they're going to go take them and they're going to use them to build. But that should drastically increase our power level. What are we up to now? Look at that, 130 megawatts straight out of nothing but these guys here. Straight out of this. We're not even using the steam engines right now, which is exactly what I wanted at the end of the day. 130 megawatts, no steam power being used, which is perfect. How How's the accumulator? 7.7 gigajoules. That's pretty substantial. But we'll have to watch for the nighttime to see if the 7.7 gigajoules is enough to cover the night. I don't know if it is. But yeah. Oh, you might notice the border. Where's the wall? There's a piece of it. Which probably means that that wasn't able to be disassembled. What did I do with the wall? Let's see. I moved it here. I realized I had cleared out all the aliens in the whole bloody area here, and I needed a very large space to build this, well, very large solar array and accumulator array. So I built it here. Nice and simple-like. There is one thing I want to do. So the greatest thing about these robots is that they can do things for you. There's no point in doing it the stupid way when you have the robots. The robots will do all the menial labor for you. It's their greatest ability. So in this case here, I want to move this section here that is overlapping, or just looks out of place, I guess. I want to move it. So boom, construction robots, go. Isn't that beautiful? Now I make another blueprint. Where are those? Blueprints. There it is. I make one more blueprint. I take the blueprint. And I select. Let's get rid of that. I believe it's that wide. 3 and 3. Yep. I take a strip on the blueprint like this. Ta-da! And I just overlay it right here. Now, that's all there is to it, kiddos. So, again, I think the bots are going to find themselves not having enough of those, because I don't think I have a facility that makes them, so I'll just punch a whole bunch in, give them to them right now. No, they had enough. So, I don't think we are able to get that down in time, unfortunately. Yeah, we still have 7.3 gigajoules, but we don't have any of these guys. I don't think they're going to be filled up, because, no, they are. All right, now they're being used. All right, so let's see what 7.3 gigajoules, partially 7.3 gigajoules of accumulator capacity will do us for the night. Steam engines are kicking on. Here's the change now, is that basically the production and consumption at nighttime, it basically ramps on these guys 100% to what is needed. This isn't 100% of the available power. This is what's 100% needed, and the accumulators make up the difference. So at nighttime, and this is exactly how I wanted it to set up, at nighttime, the accumulators and the steam engines, the accumulators, their main job now is to buffer. So the accumulators and the steam engines will produce all the power we need at night. During the day, as you see, the accumulators kicked off because they don't need to be on anymore. And they're just going to suck massive. There you go. See that drop? Right there, that drop is the, it's switching back over to what we actually need. When the accumulators are on, it doesn't have this extra capacity because it's kind of maxing out, showing exactly what you are required to use at the moment, and that's all that you get. So now we're going to see, watch, we're going to see this here. These steam engines are going to ramp down drastically as the solar panels take over. I think I need a few more solar panels, truth be told. Just give me some buffering zone, because I'm kind of like a little bit, still a little bit close. Like you can see here, the consumption is 128 megawatts, and our production is currently 128 megawatts. All right. But look at this. Look at the gap in the production. So we've got double, triple, quadruple the amount of energy that we have, or that we need. All right, so that gives me a humongous buffer. I do want to put down one more set of these guys here, because During the day, look at this, we've got 126 megawatts of required energy. All of that is specifically being used in, by, or produced by the solar panels. Sorry, I'm rambling on. Let me go over here and I'll show you guys what is the hard part. I'm gonna go and make a few more speed module threes. What am I getting? Steel. Steel. So I'm gonna go punch on the steel module three production and we'll see, sorry, speed module three production, and we'll see just how much the system sucks itself dry. Right now, I've been making them in 100 stacks. So stacks of 100, so two stacks at a time. Let's punch another 100 on and see how this sucker works. And there's about 40 of them just sitting in the conveyor belt. A little bit more than 40. Might be 50. 50 plus. Look at that. So they're in the conveyor belt alone. There is 62, I guess. Probably about 62 of them just sitting there in the conveyor belt. Now we got to make another 35. Let's see what happens when we try to do that. All right. So machines. I had to take the. I remember I had a whole bunch of speed modules in these things to try to speed them up. Well, that's what killed our power network. It's because adding four speed modules increases the power draw of each one machine by, 280% additional power draw. So those things started becoming close to a megawatt of power draw each. The normal power draw is 210 kilovolts. It was up almost, it was like 780 kilovolts, which is, it was something like that. I don't know the exact number. But it was substantial. It was disgustingly, disgustingly too much. Way too fracking much. So I've decided that one of the things I could do to help this system out a little bit is to... We're still not producing enough... we're not producing enough a few things here, okay? So one of the things I want to do here, and I want to see if this makes a difference, is I want to stick... That is not what I want to stick. I want to stick a couple of these chests. If I can't get around, I can't get past that. There we go. I want to stick a couple of these chests. Sticking electronic circuits onto the board. Let's see what happens when I do that. You know we have, like, ass ton of electronic circuits around. Stupid amounts, even. So we might as well take advantage of such a situation. Oh, I didn't even check to see if these things are all covered. No, they're not all covered. Because I don't have coverage in the middle of this block. Frack! Frack me. It's just one thing after another. It really, really is. I think this is outside of the coverage here. I don't think they will deliver to a box that's in this spot. I really have no way of being able to add another RoboPort into the clump here. RoboPorts require five A space of 5? I have nowhere in here that can give me that kind of space. Like, at all. So is it just that the two tracks here? Yeah, it seems like it's just those two tracks that aren't covered. I'm gonna put it down anyways and just see if it will deliver to it or not. I don't think it will. The green zone, if you don't know, is like excuse me, the range of the robots when it comes to things like production, or sorry, like the blueprints and supply and repair. So anything in the green zone can get repaired. You can use like the blueprint on it. Orange zone is the delivery distance, I'm pretty sure. We'll try it out and just hope for the best, I guess. At the end of the day, I don't care. It's like, whatever. I'm just trying to give this thing a little extra push. If it works, it works. If it doesn't work, I just, whatever. Screw it. No, it worked. Okay. I wasn't 100% sure it would. I thought that green zone wasn't enough to allow for requests. But I'm happily wrong. Now, the reason I'm doing this, I've got 23,000 electronic circuits in my logistics network. Why the hell not, right? If I have got 23 freaking thousand of them, I might as well put some of that to use. let these robots, which I have 3,482 of, do some freaking work around here and earn their goddamn keep. Time to earn your keep. And it's not like I'm really flooding the board either. It's just a little additional extra couple of circuits to help make up for the lack that these stupid machines are not getting, basically, because I can't produce. I set this up in a way that it's kind of a fool design on my part. Only 3 of these machines get enough copper plates. I didn't put enough copper plates. Now, what do I have for copper plates in the inventory system? I suppose I could just build a copper production facility right here, or even just go a step further and build like this. What the hell am I? What are these called? Copper cable. Jesus. Sorry. Copper cable. I could build a copper cable production and then just have them ferry it back and forth to all the electronic circuit machines. I could do that. Is there a space I could put it? Not really. I don't have space to do that, though. It's just one thing after another. It really, 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 really is. Just one odd damned thing after a goddamn another. Why aren't you getting any... Are you outside of the range? Is that... This is the one bloody... No, I wasn't wrong. The two that are in the green zone aren't getting it. I thought I was wrong, but I'm not. The two in the green zone don't get it because they aren't in the orange area. So there you go. It's what I thought, and it is what it is. Green zone ones can't get received. And I can't put another RoboPort anywhere in here because I don't, even if I wanted to, I don't have space for 5, as you can see here. Like, there's no conceivable area in the entire spot that can keep 5. Or like a 5 space here. It's nothing. I didn't plan this very well. I'm aware. Now we should have 100. Yep, there we go. There's another 100 in there now. So let's go make another 200. Or another 100, I mean. Alright, and that'll starve the system pretty hard. But this is the reason I wanted to see this was because of this. Boom, look at that. So currently we have enough solar energy that we're doing 152 megawatts worth, but that's not enough to cover the whole system, which is exactly what I was worried about. So I need to make a few more solar panels because I need to do a little bit more than I've got. I don't remember where my solar panel production facility is. It's around here somewhere. I don't know how many solar panels I still have in inventory. Like, if I can just slap down another big fat sack of crap and hope it'll work. Solar panel production. There, I want to say it's back at the other base. Let's go take a peek. Okay, I have a feeling that the solar panels, I must have walked right past them. The accumulator production facility is here. It's right there. So that's the accumulator production. And that sucker works just fine. No issues with that one. But I don't know where the solar panel production is. I'm thinking it's probably back in the other spot there. I want to show you guys how I fixed the coal issue. If you remember correctly, I was having some serious problems with coal. I wasn't getting enough coal to all my machines. The water temperature was dropping, performance was dropping, yada, 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 yada. The problem is when you start running out of power, is that your arms don't deliver the power. And when the arms stop delivering the power, the coal stops flowing. And then the power drops further because now these boilers aren't getting coal. It's kind of a positive feedback loop. All right, so it's really lousy. Really freaking bad news. Anyways, as you'll notice here, there is no issue with power production at night any longer. It doesn't hurt that now there's only really nighttime power requirements. And as the daytime ramps up, you'll watch it in 2 seconds. This son of a bitch is going to drop way back. So there we go. Now we have a combined. Look at this. This is full power. This is full power usage. This is full power usage on our network. We're doing about... No, we're gaining more than that. So the steam engines aren't even giving me enough power throughout the night. So it's 278 megawatts. I'm going to assume is the maximum with the accumulators charging up, I would assume. Yeah, not okay, that's 93 megawatts of accumulator power being dropped in. That's a lot. So while the accumulators charge up, we need... There you go. Boom. 293 all the way down to what is actually being used in our facility, which is 180 megawatts. And the solar panels should be able to give me, when I'm done, at least 200 megawatts. That's my goal. So let's go back and put the last of the solar panels down with the blueprints. One thing I want them to fix in one of the next patches is they really need to make the refineries smarter than they are. Right now, the refineries, when they're running, produce... We'll bring one up here to show you. They produce... Oh, frack you. Anyways, it's right actually here. There we go. They produce 3 heavy oil, 3 light oil, and 4 petroleum, right? And then you can upgrade them to do the majority of them being petroleum. So then you end up with 1 heavy oil, 4.5 light oil, which becomes more petroleum because that's the whole purpose of this one, is to produce massive amounts of petroleum. The issue is this. They need to make these machines smarter so that if one series of tanks is full, like oil, for example, which you can see, crude oil, there we are. Crude oil tank, 2.5. That means the whole crude oil network, we have 2.5 in this one tank alone. The whole thing's full. The pipes, all the storage containers, they're all full. But look at this. This is all we have for petroleum right now. In this pipe is zero. There is zero petroleum in this pipe. The reason for it is one of, and I don't know which one, but it's probably going to be heavy oil in this case because we were using that exclusively earlier. And we'll see in a second when I get to the chemical production facility. Heavy oil. Yep, look at that. Heavy oil tank full. Light oil tank empty. Petroleum empty. And do these things turn on to produce more? No, because one series of tanks storage facility is full. Just one. So none of the other ones will produce. So these things don't produce anything unless every tank has an equal amount of space. But that doesn't make any sense because the heavy oil is only used really for lubricant, or I can make solid fuel out of it. But it doesn't serve any purpose. So I built something to fix that issue. And it's an end game item as well. So because of the fact that I need more petroleum in my network, if I want to be able to produce things like sulfur, thank God I have buffers on everything. Boom. I set this thing up. Make a little bit more heavy oil production. In turn, it should turn on and start making some petroleum and some light oil. But that, of course, isn't going to be enough. It's never going to be enough. All right, so this thing's actually doing its job. That's good to see. The bots going back and forth is how I know that is working. I need more of the other oils, right? Like I just do. I need light oil, and I've got a light oil to petroleum production facility right here. And I need more petroleum. So the only thing I can really do to fix that issue is I need a chemical plant. Let the robots bring me some chemical plants. Alright, so the only way to really solve this problem is to have a chemical plant producing light oil, which then will go to the production facility that makes the petroleum gas. So, yeah, this is the only way to really... Excuse me, frog in my throat. Excuse me for a second. Sorry about that. Good old Evan Better needed to make some money on the streets. Computer equipment's expensive. If you know what I mean. So here we go. Let's do one last little addition. Let's bring some speed module 3s into my inventory here. And this is going to produce light oil, as you can see here. The light oil is going up and down, up and down. And the chemical plants, or the refineries, are all kicking on full gear now because they are now producing what I require. If the robots can hurry the frack up, I don't know why they're taking their sweet-ass time lately. That's why you can't rely on those guys. They're just bloody reliable. As there we go. That's gonna be a lot of power draw. Wow, this thing is drawing a whole megawatt now. This one facility, normally it's 420 kilowatts, 1 megawatt of power. That is why, ladies and gents, don't frick around with this. Don't get crazy with these speed upgrades, okay, until you've got the power network to back it up, because they are stupid. What's this thing putting out? This thing's now at 504. The normal one's 210. No. Energy consumption. Drain 7 kilowatts. What? I don't know what that's supposed to mean. Drain 7 kilowatts. Well, no. Your consumption is... I don't know. Ugh. Doesn't matter. Also, pay attention to the pollution number. Look at the pollution number, 4.32 now. All right, that's the kind of thing that can really mess up your day if you're not careful. So, 1 whole megawatt of power draw now. Keep that in mind if you ever decide to use speed modules. All righty. I'm going to finish building the rest of the solar panel network to give us at least that 180 megawatt cap of our daily usage when we have production going on. What the frack? I made it too wide. I missed a spot. Whoops. My bad. Anyways, I'm gonna finish this, guys. And next episode, I think maybe it's time to build the train network really far away and just go out there and explore this wilderness. Alright, maybe we'll take the south train and we'll just keep going south with it. And we'll see how far we can get before, like, it's anarchy down there. Alrighty, so thank you very much for watching. Make sure you leave those likes, favorites, subscribe. Helps me out a lot. Leave a comment in the comment section. I do read every single comment. And I will see you guys all in the next episode of Evan Better Presents. Thanks for watching.